We know from history that epidemics, pandemics, and certainly worldwide pandemics, while rare, they do happen and they seem to cycle. A governmental response over time has been driven by the level of medical knowledge available at that time. Sometimes geographical barriers like mountains and oceans that limited travel actually did more perhaps than governmental policy in that regard to the spread of these certain things. Others had to do with changes in communication, the level of communication, the extent that communication could be put out and so forth. But political and religious philosophies have also been major determiners in pandemic response over time. The same factors that drive the worldwide and U.S. response today in regard to COVID-19 is all a bit reflective of what we've seen over time. So what fundamental principles should guide a proper and effective pandemic response? Do you wait until it happens? Do you do some things ahead of time in case? However, we're going to talk now with Dr. Jane Orient about that perspective. Jane, pandemic response, as I just mentioned, we know it's directed by politics, ideology, pragmatics, medical science, or the lack of it. In the case of this COVID-19 policy, Dr. Fauci, that's his perspective, he's likely probably doing more to drive government response than anyone. President Trump is trying to balance his input with the economic, political, and other considerations, since this issue is really touching all of our culture. So from a medical perspective, let's just go there from your perspective, from a medical perspective, what can you lay down as some fundamental driving principles that should guide us in preparing for pandemics, because they do occur, versus responding to the reality of one that we have right now? So put it in context of preparation. I'm very curious what you would say.
I think our ability to respond to a pandemic is no better now than it was in 1918, despite the fact that in recent decades, the government has spent $80 billion purportedly for that purpose. Dr. Fauci was in charge of the response to the H1N1 swine flu influenza epidemic, which might have been as bad or worse than this one. It's hard to tell since this one is not over. He was very laid back then. He did not recommend any of these draconian quarantine measures. And during that pandemic, 100 million medical masks were used up. That was in our national stockpile, and a deliberate decision was made not to replace them. That was in 2009. Now, during the Schwarzenegger administration in California, California had a couple of mobile disaster hospitals and a lot of stockpiled equipment like ventilators and protective equipment. And in the Jerry Brown administration, those were all gotten rid of. So even the preparedness that we've had in the past has been deliberately gotten rid of for various political reasons. In addition, we used to make most of our medical masks here in the United States, and those were outsourced to China decades ago, as were our drug manufacturing capabilities. As Rosemary Gibson pointed out in her book, China RX, the United States can no longer even make penicillin or aspirin or vitamin C or most of the antibiotics, or really 90% of the critical drugs that we rely on. So even if you don't get COVID-19, but you have some other illness, you may not be able to get your prescription refilled because either the drug itself or the essential precursors came from China, and China's either not making them or they're keeping them for themselves. They're not sending them here at the present time. So there has been decades of political policy that has weakened American ability to respond to these pandemics or other crises, which inevitably are going to occur.